Welcome back to Morning After, everyone. 10:16 here on this Tuesday morning. And over the last few years, the conversation around plant-based or vegan diets has really sort of ramped up, especially when we talk about the health benefits of it. But there's a lot to think about, a lot to navigate. Cynthia Nevels is founder and head creative chef of Soulgood. It's a vegan quick service restaurant, a food truck, a bakery, a catering company. She does it all, and she's joining us this morning. Hey, Chef Cynthia.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Yeah, when I say there's a lot to consider when people shift vegan, it seems to me over the last, maybe you can quantify this better than I can, 10 years or so, the taste, the textures, the appeal of vegan food for somebody who's non-vegan, it's really improved. What accounts for that change, do you think?
Sure. We have become part of the mainstream, and that's because we've made vegan food more relatable to the everyday consumer. They can connect to it and taste what they are used to traditionally when they used to eat animal-based food. So it's just become more relatable, I do believe.
Yeah, there's so many great flavors and textures that you can put together. And we're not necessarily talking always about coming up with a product that mimics meat, right?
No, we're not, actually. You can make wonderful things with natural vegetables and fruit without having to have alternative meat products.
Yeah, in fact, a lot of vegans say, no, I don't want meat and I don't want anything that's a meat substitute. I want to learn to appreciate the tastes and the flavors and the recipes of fully plant-based. Let me ask you this. The cost of produce, access to produce in neighborhoods where there are food deserts, all of that is of concern to some people, the cost, again, being top of mind. You have a solution for that, and one that I hadn't really considered. You want people to go to the local farm co-op for delivery. How does that work in Dallas and DFW?
Yeah, there are several co-ops that exist, actually, that you can look up online that actually collect produce direct from farmers here in the general area. And then you can set up a delivery each week for the hot produce, I guess you could say, that's in season to be delivered straight and direct to your home.
And farmhouse delivery is one that you like that's local.
Yes, it is actually, and it makes their platform makes it extremely easy to select what you're looking for and schedule that delivery.
Also, learning to cook vegan, even if you're a cook, it can be a shift. You recommend people maybe start with some delivery services to work meals into their diets. What are some of your favorites?
Yeah, so you have Life Plate Meals, you have Evolved Meals, you have Chef Cassandra's new go-to meals, and then you also have Nature's Plate up in Plano.
So just Google all those, they're all local, and you can get prepared meals. You find that a good way for someone to kind of lean into some of the feel and flavor of plant-based dishes?
Yes, it makes it much easier for those who do not have the skill to cook. That's one of the barriers that many consumers talk about is, I don't know what to cook. I'm not a chef. My food doesn't taste like what I've had at the restaurant. Mm-hmm. And so what happens is they'll kind of fall off of their plan because they get bored with just eating soup and salad.
We've seen more urban gardens. We've seen community gardens in areas of our city, but we've also seen even apartment dwellers putting small gardens on their terraces and patios. We've had Donna Letier here from gardenuity.com. She ships you a garden to your home. Are you recommending, as someone evolves in their vegan way of life, that they go that direction?
If your schedule allows, I feel that it is therapeutic when you introduce a garden into your life. You know, when we were shut down during the pandemic, we saw a lot of people actually building their own gardens in their backyards and actually continued after they went back to work and things kind of gotten back to normal to raise their own foods. It's just healthier. You know the source, you know where it comes from, and it tastes better, in my personal opinion, if it hasn't been shipped from 1,000 miles away.
Yeah. I mentioned Gardenuity. You like Restoration Farm as well. You say they sell kits and seeds and directions and can help those of us who don't have a green thumb maybe have like a slightly green thumb. Congratulations, by the way, on your success. Let people know your restaurant's in Denton, correct?
Yes, we are opening our new flagship restaurant location in Denton, Texas, January 18th.
Well, I know these have been challenging times with COVID. So I know you've seemed to have met those, and opening days around the corner. So congratulations, and thank you for your insight this morning. We really appreciate it.
Appreciate your time.
That is Chef Cynthia Nevels, founder and head creative chef of Soulgood. You can go to eatsoulgood.com. She's also everywhere you are there on social media. And we want to remind you there's a job fair in Dallas, January 5th, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., and also in Denton, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Cynthia will be there as well. You could work for her and her many ventures.